Hey everyone, and welcome back to our channel. We appreciate all of the support, feedback, and video suggestions from all of you. We're glad you're enjoying the content. Today we're going to cover the 5 shift factors of the supply curve. We already made a similar video about the 5 demand curve shift factors, so be sure to check that video out if you need a refresher. With that said, let's get right into it. So if you have any knowledge of basic economics, then you're familiar with the concept of supply and demand. The supply and demand curves are plotted on a graph with price on the vertical axis and quantity on the horizontal axis. The law of supply states that as prices increase, quantity supplied increases, hence why the supply curve is positively sloped. So what causes a change in quantity supplied? Well, any change in the price of the good or service itself. Typically, as the price of a good increases, you would supply more due to the law of supply. This would imply a movement to the right along the supply curve. If prices decreased, you would move to the left along the supply curve. Well, that seems pretty easy. So if a change in price of the good changes quantity supplied, causing a movement along the supply curve, then what constitutes a change in the supply or a shift in the entire supply curve itself? Well, that would simply be all the factors not including the price of the good or service. We've summarized all of the supply curve shift factors up into a list of the following 5 shift factors: input prices, prices of related goods in production, technological advancements, producer expectations, and the number of firms in the market. Now let's explain what each of these shift factors mean and provide a few examples. First, we have input prices. Firms want to make maximum profit, and to do so, they must minimize their costs. When the price of an input into production or a factor of production, such as land, labor, machinery, etc., increases, producing that good becomes less profitable. When profits decrease, firms make less money and therefore they produce fewer goods, causing a shift in the supply curve to the left. However, the opposite is also true. If the cost of a factor of production decreases, then the supply will increase, causing a shift to the right of the supply curve. The second shift factor is prices of related goods in production. Goods can be substitutes in production, complements in production, or not related at all. In the case of substitutes in production, if the selling price of one good increases, meaning it becomes more profitable to produce that good, the supply of that good will increase, and therefore the supply of the other substitute good will decrease because it is relatively more expensive to make than the cheaper good. In the case of complements in production, if 2 goods are produced together, an increase in the price of one of these goods will increase the quantity supplied for that good and thereby increase the supply of the complementary good. Third, we have technological advancements. Technological advancements lead to more efficient production. In turn, this makes goods relatively cheaper to produce, similar but not quite the same as the first shift factor. Increased profits mean that supply will shift to the right as firms decide that they want to supply more at this lower cost of production. Fourth, we have producer expectations. If a firm thinks that the price of the good they produce is going to increase in the future, they will decrease their supply for the good today. That way, they will sell less at today's lower price and sell more at that future price, that is the higher price, thereby increasing the profits. The same is true for the reverse scenario. If firms expect the price of a good to decrease in the future, they will increase current supply in an attempt to capitalize selling at a higher price today and making more in profits. It is important that you do not confuse this with a change in current prices. This is just expectation. A change in current prices would simply lead to a change in quantity supplied and a movement along the curve. Lastly, we have a pretty straightforward shift factor, and that's the number of firms. As the number of firms producing goods in a given market increases, the total supply of goods in that market would increase as well. For example, suppose that there are 2 bakeries in your neighborhood. If a 3rd bakery were to open up, that would increase the total supply of baked goods in the market and therefore shift the supply curve for the baked goods to the right. To summarize everything we talked about in this video, a movement along the supply curve is caused by a change in the price of the good or service itself. A shift in the supply curve is caused by any of the 5 shift factors: input prices, prices of related goods in production, technological advancements, producer expectations, and the number of firms in the market. So there you have it. Now you know the difference between a change in quantity supplied or a movement along the supply curve and a change in supply or a shift in the entire supply curve. If you like this video and are excited to see more, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment what sort of economic topics you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.